My research is involved with frogs and atrazine. Atrazine is a common herbicide used in North America and primarily in the Midwestern United States, but also in New Jersey. Atrazine has a tendency to leach into soil, which causes it to end up in groundwater and then end up in ponds and wetlands or in surrounding areas of agricultural areas. And this is harmful to frogs or to aquatic life in general, but we specifically looked at frogs and their gonadal development, which is their reproductive organs, because the growing season actually also correlates with the period of time where frogs are growing from tadpoles to frogs. So it affects their development. My specific role in this project was to come up with a better way of a radio amino assay, which is a whole body assay. Tadpoles are really small. We use Xenopus laevis, which is a really small frog, and they are too small to take blood samples. In a lizard or other animals, you could take blood samples and do a plasma assay, which we centrifuge the plasma and we test that separately. In frogs, such as Xenopus laevis, they're too small, so we have to do a whole body assay where we homogenize the whole tadpole and then do testing based on that. Plasma assays have efficiency of an average of 80%, and whole body assays have at best efficiency of 50%, so that's much less efficient. My role in the assay was to optimize the whole body radioamino assay, and I did this by incorporating a hexane wash in my methods in order to get better results. I work with Dr. Henry John-Alder, and I got involved with him through a research mixer. There was many different faculty members looking for undergraduates to help them with research, and I just really enjoyed what he was working on and wanted to work with him. And he also seemed like a professor I would want to get involved with. I just like really enjoyed the experience. I actually work for the Rutgers Foundation, so I speak to a lot of people over the phone. You know, Rutgers is one of the top research universities in the country, and I'm just really happy that they offer this to its undergraduates, because I know a lot of other universities, probably smaller universities, but maybe even state universities, don't offer this much experience to undergraduates, and if they do, it's minimal and much more difficult to find a research opportunity. And I just felt like it was really easy to get involved with something and, you know, get a lot of really great experiences.